A new survey says almost three quarters of wholesale investors say now is a good time to invest. The research by Wholesale Investor magazine says high net worth investors, senior executives and so-called angel investors are amongst those who are cashed up and looking for opportunities. The Business Channel Sky Chow spoke to Reuben Buchanan from Wholesale Investor and asked him about the buying opportunities for such enthusiastic private equity players.
I think that either they're a little bit cautious, there's still a bit of caution in the public and private markets about whether we have actually reached the bottom, if there's going to be any more drops in the listed space, and also too the kinds of companies that they're buying, companies that they maybe thought were stable maybe 18 months or 12 months ago, maybe they're not so stable now because you're seeing some big companies falling over. So there's still a little bit of caution in the marketplace, but the optimism is still, I think, 50% of the investors being quite optimistic about putting money into the market right now, whether it's public or private companies, I think is still a pretty positive result. If you had have asked me before we did the survey what the optimism level was, I would have probably said it might have been maybe only 25%, but we actually thought that that was quite strong.
Now, 80% of them have more than half of their funds in cash at the moment, so they're all ready to pounce then.
Well, basically, what the investors are recognising is now's a good opportunity. They've cashed up a lot of some of their positions, or maybe sold some property, knowing that now's going to be a good time to actually pick up some cheap investments. A lot of the money is actually sitting on the sidelines, so 80% of them have half of their money or more sitting on the sidelines in cash, ready to actually pounce on good opportunities. So if you look at the kinds of opportunities that what the survey is saying, the sort of opportunities they're looking at, mostly private companies, right, direct equity, and also some distressed assets as well. So anything that's going cheap is something that they'd be interested in.
So if they're on the lookout for bargains, I suppose property must be a very popular area?
Well, if the investors that we surveyed, property actually came down the list, probably about halfway down the list. The top sectors that they were most interested in, which was surprising, was industrial and engineering. Clean tech and green tech came second. And education actually come up third as the most sought-after sectors to go into.
So why is the industrial and engineering sector so popular with wholesale investors?
Firstly, it's a stable industry. It's an existing sector. Clean tech and green tech, although it's exciting, it's still unproven. And also, too, there's a lot of revenue being pumped into industrial and engineering sector through the government spend and the stimulus packages and so on.
So if the industrial and engineering sector is quite stable, but the green or clean sector is quite speculative, then is it safe to say then that there's no real pattern when it comes to risk profile of the preferences of wholesale investors?
We found with the investors that the thing that they were most interested in was the actual quality of the management. Things like proven track record and so on actually came a little bit further down the survey results, but as long as the business has had good management, right, and proof of concept, they actually ranked quite highly.
And most investors, they're only interested in taking a small stake, aren't they, within an investment, maybe 20% of a company?
I think the nature of it being an investor is not to control the company. You want to back good entrepreneurs who are going to actually take the company and run with it. When an investor gets into a control position, that usually means things have gone wrong and they're trying to rescue the deal. So most of the investors, a very high percentage of them, are only interested in a stake of around about 20%. In the company, as opposed to trying to control the company or control the entrepreneur. They really want to put their money to work, get the entrepreneurs to actually run the business for them, and therefore they're not after an overly huge stake. And that's sort of the nature of private equity and a lot of angel investors.
And that wraps up Business Report for this Friday and for the week from the team here. Thank you so much for your company. I'm Bridie Barry. See you next time.